many in the industry really were questioning, can we do this?
Nothing like this has been done before. We have pushed the limits of what we thought was possible.
It's groundbreaking is what we've done. This is a world record.
No one has ever put subsea compression so far from shore at these water depths. This is the Nyhamna gas plant. Gas from the second largest gas field in Norway, Ormen Lange, travels to this plant where it's processed and then exported to Europe. We've been powering hundreds of millions of homes and businesses in the last 20 years of production from this field. This was the first deep water development in Norway. And ever since, we have been pushing those boundaries in technology and human endeavor. The Ormen Lange production equipment is situated 120 kilometers offshore, nearly 1,000 meters below sea level, at the base of an 800 meter escarpment. The field itself is 40 kilometers long by 8 to 10 kilometers wide. The actual reservoir sits another 2.5 kilometers below the seabed. The equipment on the seabed includes four templates through which connections and pipelines are made. The gas is naturally forced out by the pressure within the reservoir. It travels into the equipment at each template before being mixed into two pipelines that send it back to Nyhamna for processing.
Over the course of the two decades that the field has been in production, as gas has been produced, pressure has gradually been declining. To boost this pressure has been a tough challenge. When reservoir pressure drops, gas compression is a very attractive solution to sustain production. This would normally be installed on an offshore platform, but here we installed it at the seabed. This enables us to increase the velocity of the gas in the pipeline, boosting production and allowing us to get the most out of our asset.
The whole subsea control system is remotely operated from this control room here at Nyhamna. And the power that we send from here goes a record-breaking 120 kilometers offshore to our compressors. The power from onshore first reaches the transformers. The transformers step this power down and then feed it to where the magic happens. We've installed two 800-ton compression stations on the seabed and integrated them into the existing production system. The compressor units are engineered to withstand the deep sea pressures and freezing temperatures. Inside each unit, electrically driven motors power the gas compressors. These increase the pressure and compensate for the natural pressure drop in the reservoir over time, enabling the gas to travel back to Nyhamna. Sophisticated sensors and control systems enable real-time monitoring and adjustment, all managed remotely from onshore.
These are the world's deepest subsea compressors. It's more efficient, and over the lifetime of the field, is expected to push the recovery rate from 75% to a world-class 85% and unlock 30 to 50 billion more cubic meters of gas. The additional recovery equals enough gas to heat 5 million homes next year alone. That is equivalent to a city the size of Barcelona.
These pipes might not look like much, but they're an essential part of the energy distribution system within Europe. From this tiny remote Norwegian island, gas flows thousands of kilometers across to Europe, providing reliable energy powering homes and businesses. The carbon emissions from production are also among the lowest on the Norwegian continental shelf. As the Ormen Lange field is powered by hydro-generated electricity and the gas is processed in a closed system at Nyhamna, this allows us to extract larger volume while not creating additional emissions in the processing of the gas. This project is really showing Shell's strategy in action. We're delivering more value with less emissions.
What we've done is taken a technology to the next level. Proving it can work and it can be deployable on lots of different projects.
Seeing it all come to life is an amazing feeling. It makes me very proud to be part of a team that's been pushing these boundaries.
We're maximizing the value from this field and providing reliable energy into Europe.